and Wayne Newton, and I've been lucky enough to have him with me for a long time. And Paul couldn't make it this tour, but he'll be back next year. So he sends his best wishes. And it's great to see you, President and Mrs. Carter. Happy birthday. And I know you're getting younger every day. Am I too close in your face, or does everything sound good?
Just
right. Good, okay. Well, I that first song I played, you know, in French, I might have been French in college, probably didn't know that, but La Feuille Morte, which means dead leaves, refers to autumn leaves, with the leaves falling off the trees. And the man that made that popular is a very special friend, Roger Williams. And the special thing about Roger was two things. One, he was born October the 1st, 1924, and I think we figured it out, it was close to about an hour apart, you guys.
Right, yeah.
And both men, because I've known Jimmy a lot longer, endorsed my music, and it's just so cool. And when I was at the St. Louis Symphony, after I left Orlando, and when I used to come up here all those times, Roger heard me, and he said, you need to get out of St. Louis and go to Las Vegas. And I think I've told you before that my mom was Southern, we were raised Southern Baptist, and she kind of whited out Las Vegas on the map, you know. I called and auditioned out there. First, I called a man by the name of Johnny Haig, who did our 75th Jimmy Carter birthday, and he says, why do you think I should hire you? I like to do a shake a tree and a piano player falls out. So no, you don't have to, but I ended up auditioning, and that was a long time ago, and I was there for many years, and now I'm at the Bellagio. And I'm touring, so also doing concerts. I did a master class tour through South Carolina, and I had a wonderful time teaching little kids to play the piano the last few days, helping them with their pieces at the Steinway Dealers. So, without further ado, I would like to play a little bit of Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera.
Thank you.
of the Steinway B. This is the largest piano the Steinway builds in New York City, and it weighs about 1,250 pounds. And I have to tell you, this is one of the finest ones I've played in ever any place in the world, this one you have here in America. So congratulations. And I love the sound of it. Steinway just designed a little microphone. I'll show you. Looks like a little matchbox. And it sets on the keyboard, on the harp or the piano, and you don't have to have any ugly boom stands and chords and all that. It's because of the acoustic, where it sounds like a big acoustic piano and not a mic'd piano, which we like a lot. And I hope you like the sound of it. That was on my new CD coming out. It's also out here, What a Wonderful World. So, a few of those. I want to play a little song by Hoagy Carmichael. I think you'll like it. I'm going to bring a special friend in and play it for us on Jimmy's 75th from the Spiral Staircase in Downtown Horns. Here's a little song you might know by Hoagy Carmichael. It was written about his daughter. Scotty back there?
Yep.
Don't wake up, Scotty.
Thank you.
because the best times of my life I spent right here in Sumter County over the last 30 years. Started with meeting Mr. Jimmy in a bookstore in Orlando because I always admired him so much. He was the first president that I could vote for. In August of 1976, I turned 18, and my mom was running for county clerk in Oklahoma as a Democrat, and in Ottawa County, it was a Democratic county, but she fell a few votes shy of winning, but this guy won. It was always my goal that I would meet him. So I came to a book signing when he was signing the Outdoor Journal, which mentioned a lady that's here tonight, Betty Pope. And from that point forward, I became friends with Betty Pope too, and John. And so then the long and short of it is that I gave him a record, and I think he had it to Secret Service, and it resulted in a phone call from Dan Ariel, and then I started coming up here to church. I was like a, what do you call it, charter member of long distance. About every 2 or 3 weeks we'd come up here from Orlando. So, and our kids grew up. It's just amazing, amazing memories. So, thank you. All right, let's play a little bit of Bumblebee Booth. Thank you.
Thank you.
I've spent my whole life playing the piano. I was kind of socially starved when I was a kid because in Oklahoma there wasn't a lot to do in those days, so this was it. I'm going to play some tunes that over the years I know have meant a lot to President and Mrs. Carter, and because I've just got a little medley worked up. Those Sinatra tunes, I think you deserve, I have all on CD, and if you like one of those. So here's a few tunes that we've talked about over the last few years, special to you guys. So I made a little medley of it. Thank you. Everything worked out beautifully. She got her master's degree, and now she's a nurse practitioner. And God really dealt with all of us, because I mean, I there was times I wondered if she would make it. I know you and I talked to Mom, and but thank God she did. And I don't know if you want to say anything, Katie, or no? She's quite a little trooper. When we first started coming here, I think you were a year old, weren't you? About a year old. Yeah, and she is now 27, 28. But here she is. Because you know it was so simple. All we ask is you to do something, and you do it, and it's just like that—a yes and or no. He says no sometimes, and things just get done. Now we can do anything. But we love you very much, and you know, when I was talking about Betty Godwin, she said last time I was here, she said I love the Latin stuff. So I'm going to play a few around the world music bands. We got a little more time, and this is Antonio Carlos Jobim. I'm sure you've been to Brazil a lot of times. I've never been. But when I can't speak the language, when I can't speak the language of another country and I see Brazilians coming to Bellagio from Las Vegas, I simply say Antonio Carlos Jobim. And they go, oh yeah, this guy's cool. So Scotty, let's do a little bit of Antonio Carlos Jobim. He used to sit on the beach when he was living, and once the girls go by, because you know they develop the bikinis there. And he wrote a song called The Girl from Ipanema by Antonio Carlos Jobim, followed by Summer Samba, and wave. I don't know if Scotty wants to dive back there in the back, but here he is. All right. And one lady one night got a little disturbed because I introduced this as a girl with emphysema, but it's just the girl who uses noxema. But here it is, the girl from Ipanema, Scott Barrett. Thank you.
Betty, the little short, pretty, dark-haired girl that came back, little Betty Gottlieb. Well, she told me she liked Latin music last time, so that's why we did all those Latin tunes.
Well, that's for you, Betty.
Yes. Betty likes the Latin stuff. And I don't blame her, I do too. It's fun. And that's our wonderful world if you like the stuff. Oh, you know what? Let's, before we quit, let's take some requests. A few requests. I like to, my friend Roger Williams, who was born October the 1st, 1924, said, David, you need to take requests from the audience. He said, I learned a long time ago.
Just give praise.
Give people back what they're asking for, right?
Right.
So I grew up in Oklahoma, we like steak and potatoes, you know, and stuff like that, so.
Young and Foolish.
Well, I heard something over here. What was it? Amazing Grace, one of my favorites. What else?
Nola.
Young
Nola?
And Foolish.
Oh, you want me to work, don't you? That was one of my earlier pieces.
Nola.
Nola. Young and Foolish?
Funny Valentine.
Funny Valentine.
Feather Song.
A little more plain.
Feather Song.
Oh, is that? You like that?
I love it.
From Forrest Gump. You know, I have to tell you, that reminds me of Hollywood. You know, last year I got Concert Pianist of the Year. You sure you got the right person? And they said, yes, Al Bowen with the LA Music Awards. So my tie-in here is that if you happen to see Argo, which I have not seen, it was a wonderful movie.
Go see it.
We have Bill Blair here tonight, the robot from Argo, all the way from Hollywood, California. You did a spectacular job on that. So I've got to see it, and he of course loves President Carter too. What did, do you have anything to say about the movie, or?
Well, can I?
Yeah, come on up, why not? Very quickly, we got a request, and I have my memories. This is Bill Blair from Argo.
Bill Blair from Argo.
Thank you. David's responsible for me being out here tonight, and it is such a great honor that being a part of such a movie, that this man here to my right had such a part in making it happen originally, and that when it was declassified, Ben Affleck, George Clooney, and Grant Heslov got together, and the studio said, we're going to make a movie out of this. This gentleman here had a lot of input on it, and I actually have a photo that I put together for the movie with my character, the robot, on it that I wanted to give to Mr. Carter here tonight. It says, to President Carter, thank you for your service and generosity to our country and the world. Happy birthday, Bill Blair. Because of the gentleman who's responsible for me tonight, I didn't want to leave him out. And so for this gentleman behind me here, it says, to David, thank you for your friendship and sharing your talents with the world, Bill Blair. For you, David.
Well,
thank you.
You're the first robot I've ever gotten a gift from. Okay, so I've got all those requests in my mind. Oh, and Janine Carter has just rolled in. Do you have jeans on, honey, or what?
It doesn't matter.
Come up here, we're going to press the wrong place. All right. Come on up, sweetheart. Miss Rosalind, everywhere she goes, she tells someone she's related to you. Is that your She drove like a maniac to get her from Atlanta. Janine Carter. So we have all those requests up here in the program. I've got to get it quick because I don't want to go too long. Okay, so we've got those requests. Give me some more, a few more.
Give it time.
The Shadow of Your Smile.
Okay.
Always Meant Forever.
The Shadow of Your Smile.
Is that Nancy?
Always Meant Forever.
Okay.
I'm a Cherry Hill.
What was Happy birthday, Billy.
Unchained Billy?
Sound of Music.
Okay. What? Okay. I know you have to go build for Happy Texas. Here we go.
Thank you.
positions these days. I decided I'd take a different position and play the piano. So ladies and gentlemen, if you won't take a picture, I'll play 12 Street Rag upside down and backwards. And Janine always tells me to tell people, please don't try this at home.
Musician and pianist when Rosa and I were in the White House. But I've said many times to many audiences that the greatest piano player I have ever heard is David Osborne. And I still, all of you know tonight, he's able to take the songs that we have known and loved all our lives and somehow another extract from them kind of a new dimension of melody and rhythm and vibrancy and emotion that we've never seen before. And no one else can equal what he does with piano. A lot of people, at my age said, what keeps you going, you know? Well, I've said one of the main things that keeps me going is looking forward to the next time that David's going to play for us. And he was so good with this time. He's so good with this time. I think he's 5 years old, and I knew him earlier than that. Well, anyway, on the 16th day of December, I have learned, as was announced by Rita earlier, David's going to be playing for not just a few hundred people, but for millions of people. On the morning show, right? On MSNBC. And they're doing themselves a great favor by having David Osborne come and play for us. I think in everybody's life, every now and then you meet someone that surprises you with the depth of beneficial change they bring to your life. And one of those people for me has been David Osborne. Ever since I first heard him play the piano, I've been infatuated with his music. But I've also been grateful that his family and mine have formed a partnership that will last us all for our lifetime. David, thank you for coming. God bless you. We love you very much.
I'm going to say this, and I don't want to lose it here, but you know, they listen to a lot of not bad piano playing by David Osborne, but Betty and them and all of them growing up over, you know, the last 30 years, And we did a lot of things, and Betty would say, no, don't do that again, you know, that's not, don't use a digital piano. You know, it was a lot of trial and error, and I remember when I talked to, when your mother came down to the AARP, that was back in 91, I think, 91, yeah. And you, I sat with her, and you spoke, and I told her, I said, Rosalind, I'm going to do a CD. And we're doing Atlanta, the first CD. And she encouraged me. It was so, you know, to have the encouragement from somebody like Rosalind. And I put several tunes on that first CD. And I just want you to know that I'd be nowhere without you. I mean, and coming here, you know, of course, Betty would tell me straight up, you know, right?
Right,
Betty would. So that's one thing about Betty, and I love her dearly, is that she don't mince any words. And you know, not coming, and I'm not saying Betty's not musical, but coming from somebody that's, you know, that's out on the outskirts of music, it's really the way to go, because you get the truth that way. And I keep trying to hone my talent and practice more every day. I'm at, you know, about 6 hours a day now. I just can't get enough of it. I never took any drugs, never smoked dope, never smoked any marijuana ever. This was my drug up here.
You don't need it.
I don't need it. It's just and Scott Berry. And I don't ever like to ask Mr. Jimmy for a favor, but once in a while, because I was very close to, I think, getting on Morning Joe from another couple of people that wrote in, but I one night sent him an email to Bill and I, what the heck, you know? Jimmy said, don't do it. I said, I'm going to do it. So, because I know that Mr. Brzezinski was on your, was your joint
security advisor.
National security advisor, one of the most brilliant men I've ever heard. And I used to have a lot of friends in Florida when I was coming to see them, were Polish. I learned Jak Szymas, Marzenowicz, Dobranos, and all that, you know. And when I started watching Mickey Brzezinski, she said, I just love Jimmy Carter. You have Joe Scarborough, who's the Republican side of it, and they go back and forth. But every morning at 3 a.m., when I get out of work at Bellagio, I've got Morning Joe on. And so I said, Jimmy, what the heck? I'm gonna email Jimmy and ask him. And she said, oh, don't do it. But you know, Mika loves you. So I bet if Jimmy would ask her, she would put me on the show. You know? So thank God he did. On my birthday, which was August 25th, my wife intercepted the email from Morning Joe. And she thanked President Carter, and she said, don't say nothing because I'm going to tell him on his birthday, which was August 25th. And we both cried. Do you want to say anything? No? You sure? All right, well.
Are you crying? You might as well, too.
Well, we love you, and I know you're going to go to your thing tomorrow, but next year in Dallas, I've already committed to help build houses for Habitat. I just got to keep the camera away from my hands, but I don't want to do it. Thank you for the 30 years you've done that. It's fabulous.
Thank you.
After the President and First Lady leave, if anybody wants a CD signed, I'll be happy to sign it. I know that Jeanine probably wants to get a picture with you. I don't know what you want to do. How do you want to do this?
One more. Come on up.
Bill is a class
guy. Bill,
where do
you get a picture?
Oh, he wants to. He's a class guy, Bill.
Got a camera somewhere? Everybody got a camera. I'm Hollywood.
Thank you.
Voila. Here we go. Beautiful.
That's my favorite.